bar. Coach Carol here coming to you with a lower abdominal set to work on. This is really a popular area of our abs that we all kind of want to target. So these are some great exercises to really zone in on that space. So come on down onto your back. We're going to do heel taps. So our first exercise, our knees are in a 90 degree angle. We're just going to come all the way down, lower one heel down, tap it, and then pull it back up. And the other side, heel tap and pull it back up. Just make sure that as you go, you really relax your shoulders and your neck. If you want a little bit more, you can extend it long and low, like a little hover, and then with the strength of your lower abs, you kind of pull that leg right back in. So one equals one, we're gonna do 50 of those, and then coming into some plank rocks. So we're gonna come right on down onto our forearms, and then just rock it to one side, reach your arm all the way up, and then come on down back to center. Take it to the other side, reach it all the way up, and then back down. We're doing 50 of those, so one equals one on the plank rocks. Those just feel good on your back too. And then we're gonna come into some flutter kicks. So all the way down onto your back, you can bring your hands by your side, or if you want a little bit of help, you can kind of slide them just a little bit under your hips. But you're gonna bring your legs straight. You can kick up high for a more gentle, more balanced level. Otherwise, get long and low, nice and low, low, low. We're gonna kick nice and tight. So point your toes, almost like a static crunch. So you kind of look at your tippy toes and kick, kick, kick. Just count your right foot. So two equals one, we're gonna do 50 of those. And then right into some roll-ups. So we're gonna start, I love this one because there's some nice stretches in the middle of our roll-up. So stretch it out, reach your arms away from your legs, lift your arms up. You're gonna lift it up, nice big roll up, and then just reach forward. And then same idea on the way down, so we lift it up, and then roll it down one vertebrae at a time, back in that stretch. So arms coming up, lifting it up. You can even come into a really nice stretch right here, if you wanna put that in there. Lift it up, and then all the way down. So we're doing 50 of those roll ups, and then we're gonna come into scissor kicks. So same idea, like a flutter kick, but your legs are gonna crisscross. So hands by your side, or maybe slightly under your hips. So you can scissor kick, again, from up high, a little more gentle to kick from there. Otherwise, maybe lower your legs. Take your legs out a little bit wider, then hip width apart, a little crisscross. So out, cross, 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 cross. So take little breaks if you need to. One equals one on those. We're gonna do 50 of those. And then my personal favorite, we're gonna come into a reverse curl to finish this out. So hands by your side, you're gonna bring your knees up into your chest. So you wanna pin your knees up into your chest, almost like you're hugging your knees in, but without your arms, right? So we're here. So we're gonna tippy toe touch down and pull our knees in, a little reverse curl, tippy toes down, a little reverse curl, down, up, and really squeeze that lower belly, especially on that nice lift, but you can feel it right where you want to work it. So you're going to do 50 of those. So just do the best you can if you want to start with a lower number of reps to kind of get through all those exercises. Perfectly fine. And then as the week progresses, maybe adding on more repetitions and ultimately see if you can get through the whole set twice to equal 600 reps. Have fun. Thanks, you guys.